We are in the Roadshow Kitchen this morning. Discover Newport Chef Rob Biela, Pour Judgement Bar and Grill, and we are in heaven today. We're making beer-braised pulled pork and coleslaw. Thanks for coming in.
You're welcome. Thank you.
All right, let's go over some of the ingredients because this is a major piece of meat here.
Yeah, we've got a nice pork shoulder right here, and basically it's bone in. You get it anywhere you want, BJ's, Stop and Shop. You don't have to go and order from a fancy butcher
right.
or whatnot. But and we also have a little... Small head of cabbage, mm-hmm. enough to feed an army.
That's okay. We have an army around here, trust me.
Awesome. Yeah, today it's very simple. We're just doing beer-braised pork, and we're going to use a little Worcestershire sauce, some red pepper chili flakes, and basically some garlic.
And this is a real, like you were saying, this is a real easy recipe. Somebody can, you know, prepare this in the morning before they go off to work, and you know, put everything, mix everything together, and you're good to go.
Yeah, today we're using nothing, but you can use a crock pot and whatever you want when you're at home.
Okay, now when we're going to, you know, the market looking for, you know, the piece of meat, what do we got to look for?
You know, well, I like it with the bone in. Some people, you'll find them with the bone out. It's not a big deal.
But the bone in, it would have, you know, has a little different flavor to it, or adds better flavor to it.
Some people say it adds a little more flavor. I feel like most of the ingredients that you put in the pot
will help it out.
You know, and the bone is real nice. But you're looking for a nice, you know, a nice firm cut of meat.
Okay.
And usually on the pork butt, it usually has, you know, good marbling in it, little fat.
Right.
And it braises really, really well.
Okay. And we're going to add beer to this, right?
We're going to add beer.
Now, people don't have to panic at home that if, you know, they can still feed it to their kids at home.
Yeah, the alcohol cooks off. You don't want to add beer, you don't have to add beer.
Right, you don't have to add beer.
Add some water or add some chicken stock or what say you, you know. It doesn't have to have beer.
And get everything together. Okay.
Beer makes it
taste
better.
This will be an easy recipe. Somebody can whip up before they go to work, throw everything together, and they will be good to go, and the house will smell fantastic
simple,
when you get home.
Minimalist. It's the perfect thing for, you know, the soccer mom, and, you know, she's got stuff going on.
Right. Yeah. Okay. All right. So we have our ingredients ready to go. I'm in heaven, and we'll be back in just a little bit and put everything together.
Back to the kitchen. How's it going, Michaela?
Well, can't you see how it's going? I am surrounded by a lot of beer right now. I'm also surrounded by Chef Rob and Hank from the Newport Craft Beer Festival. So excited to have you guys on. Tell us what this is all about.
It's a benefit for the Newport Historical Society. We're going to be held at a location, one of the oldest buildings in town, called the Great Friends Meeting House. It is going to be 30-plus breweries, four local restaurants, and two bands, Well Strung and The Throttles.
Nice. And what can people expect to see while they're there, in addition to all of this?
Well, with the 30 breweries, we're going to have probably about 2 to 3 samples per brewery.
Oh, okay.
So you're going to have probably about 80 to 90 beers there.
Mm-hmm. And touch upon some of the ones that you brought along.
Okay, the vast emphasis is going to be on New England beers.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of upstart ones, especially in Rhode Island right now. You just got Grace Ale out of Westerly.
Okay.
You got Revival is brewing out of Trinity up in Providence.
Mm-hmm.
And you got a lot of new upstarts, say like Mayflower, which is out of Plymouth, Mass.
Yeah, we'll take a look at that one.
Yep.
Great.
But there will be some West Coast representation as well. You've got Lagunitas out of California, Full mm-hmm. Sail out of Hood River. That's Oregon, and then Stone out of California as well.
So stuff from all over. And the dish that we're making today, Chef, I mean, that beer must pair well with it, right? Beer?
Pairs amazing. You know, we're using a spring ale today from Newport mm-hmm. Storm, which is, you know, obviously the sponsor, but it's an Irish style red ale, and it's a great beer.
Nice.
Pairs real well with the pork.
Excellent. Good to know. And what should people know? Do they need to purchase tickets in
advance? We're selling out almost. The two locations you can get them are at Pour Judgement down in Newport
mm-hmm.
and at the website for Newport Storm in the gear store. But we have to cap it. The location is unique, but it's also small.
Right.
So we have to cap it at 500 sales, and we're already over 300. So
all right. Get your tickets very fast. Do you have a favorite out of these? Or there's too many to choose from.
No, I could probably lean in.
Here we go. We're opening them up. It's a party on the road show. Here we go. What's that one? The Full Sail?
Full Sail Amber.
Excellent. All right. Well, we are going to taste some of these and get the dish going in just a little bit. Back to you. We are cooking with Discover Newport in the kitchen today. Chef Rob from Pour Judgement Bar and Grill joins us to make beer-braised pulled pork and coleslaw. A mouthful. Literally.
You're our hero today.
It is.
Yes.
Well, thank you very much.
Will
like
has been singing your praises all morning.
The ultimate comfort food today.
Okay.
Big time, especially for a beer fest. This will settle your stomach, you know, on a good drinking day, that's for sure.
It'll keep you going throughout the entire festival, yep. Okay.
But first of all, you know, we're going to start with a nice pork shoulder. We're going to trim the fat off. You don't have to, if you want to. It's up to you, you know.
We're going just, a little healthier
yeah,
today.
Yeah, a little healthier, you know. There's a lot of good marbling in the actual pork shoulder, but very, very simple. If you're not a knife person, use a butter knife. Just that easy,
yeah.
You know. And then, very, very simple. Afterwards, if you want, you can salt it. We just throw some salt in there.
Just put a little salt on it.
A little salt, go for it. Yeah, salt it generously, that's okay. Once it gets out of the pot, you know.
I like salt, back off.
Right, some pepper. It's all right, we're going to braise this. A lot of the salt and stuff is going to be in the liquid with the beer. But
you get the first bite of that one.
Right after that, that's basically all that has to touch the cutting board. You go right into the pot with this, and then we're going to take our Worcestershire sauce. If you don't have Worcestershire, soy sauce. Don't go run out and buy it. Anything crazy.
Simple
so we got Worcestershire, yeah. People usually have pepper flakes kicking around.
Yeah,
just throw that right in there too. It's all in there. Don't worry about it. It's spicy, but it's supposed to be spicy for this dish.
Okay.
We're doing a little.
I like that.
Yep.
And it's supposed to be salty, apparently too.
It is. Yeah.
So, hey, I did that, so now we can drink more beer later.
Perfect.
We gotta keep keep hydrated.
Yeah, yeah. And just a clove of garlic.
Okay.
And you know what? I'm just gonna cut it in half.
Okay.
Wow. If I can. Break it apart. You don't even have to take the cloves out of the thing. Don't peel it. Throw
just right in there. Okay, so it's just going to absorb all of that, those flavors
that are
in there. Yeah,
because we're not going to use the liquid as a sauce or anything like that. That's just a vessel to cook the meat and braise it, which is a moist and dry cooking. So next, if you want, you can throw some beer in there. We got some beer here. We got a nice Irish Spring Ale. You know,
there we go.
See how much beer goes in here.
Throw about five of those in there. Just get it in there. You want to cover it with about 3/4 worth of liquid for the braising process.
Well, while I'm pouring, remind everyone where you guys are located.
Yeah, we're located right on Broadway down in Newport. And we're right downtown. And you're within walking distance from everywhere. You're in a hotel. From everywhere. We're down in Newport. You're on a boat. Come up and see us. You know, you're down there for the take the ferry in. Walk right up.
And go right to see it.
Yes.
Very
and,
nice.
And if I go in, I can have this?
If you go in there, you can have it. Oh, yeah.
It won't be a salty, but...
If you don't have a pot or a roasting pot, don't freak out, you know, just whatever. You could use a regular pot. It doesn't matter.
I like this. You're making it easy.
Put that in.
Piece cake. You know, just take that. We'll go right into the oven.
Okay.
275 degree oven for about 4 hours until it...
Nice and tender.
You know, but... Same thing. If you don't want to fire the oven up, it's pot in the summertime. Put the crock pot on.
Same thing in the crock pot.
Nice.
Same thing in the crock pot.
Okay.
Same exact thing. Just keep it nice and low and let it do its work.
Okay. Next up, we have coleslaw.
This is going to tie it all together.
Ooh.
Yep. Starting with some mayonnaise.
Got it. How much mayonnaise are we?
We've got about a half a cup of mayonnaise.
Okay.
Just for this.
For these, you can make it as spicy or as salty or as mayonnaise-y.
Next step, we got some cider vinegar. We're adding a little acid to it. Mm-hmm. It's going to help bring the pork and the spiciness.
You're up there, Michaela.
Yeah. And then we got some sugar, too. We're going to add some sugar in there, the sweetness. Just throw it all in there.
Sugar's
good. Okay. We got spicy and we got sweet and we got sour mixing in there. We're also throwing some whole grain mustard.
I love whole grain mustard.
Now, you're using the whole grain. Can we use...
Dijon mustard.
Okay.
You know, the whole grain gives it a nice texture and in your mouth and whatnot. Mm-hmm. But I wouldn't use
that.
I wouldn't use the yellow mustard.
No, it's not the same flavor.
If you don't have it, don't have to run out. Just skip it and just go like that. Just throw it in a bowl.
But that whole grain, it has a great taste to it.
Yeah,
as well. It has you know the texture of it and everything else.
Yeah, I was going to say I kind of like the bite that it gives it.
Right. Yeah.
Oh wow, that's coming together great.
And coleslaw is always the perfect summer, you know, summer side dish to go along with.
And it's so easy, doesn't it? Like this just took literally not even 3 minutes to make. You do this, you put it in the oven, you go on with your day.
Yeah, let's see the finished one. You have one.
Yeah, we do.
In
we
the
actually
oven,
put one
right?
in the oven a little earlier and
yeah.
Let's break that out and see what that looks like.
Step on the side.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
Here, man.
There it is, the big unveil.
Unbelievable.
Wow, look at that.
Most of it, little of the liquid had reduced.
Mm-hmm.
But what you want to do is go in there and
just break it.
Just get right in there
nice.
After about 3.5-4 hours. So basically that's what you're left with.
And then that's the finished product. Wow, that looks so good. This
is falling right off the bone.
That's what you want.
You'd be able to, pull it with your fork.
Will's mouth is watering.
You
just give him that fork.
There you go.
I'm just going to take this. Okay, if you want this recipe, just head to our website, WPRI.com.